Welcome to the Happy Trails Theater.
Roy, I know this is a very special picture that the folks are going to see. Would you like to say how you got into the picture business and what happened?
Well, it was under Western Stars, and it was probably I got a bigger thrill out of making my first picture than any of the rest of them.
Naturally.
For that reason, and how it came about, I came out to Republic Studios. I was on radio with the Sons of the Pioneers, which was my group at that time, and I had one of my hats being cleaned out at a little hat store out in Glendale, California.
Mm-hmm.
And I was out there getting ready to pick it up, and all of a sudden the door busts open, and a great tall guy came running in, and he was all excited. He's about the size of John Wayne.
Ooh.
His name was Carter. I'll never forget it. And he was all excited and telling me he was going to have a screen test, and they were looking for a new singing cowboy. And so I got to talking to him and find out it's out at Republic Studios. So I saddled my guitar the next morning and went out to the studios, and I couldn't get in because of, I didn't know anybody. So I sat around and waited, and the security guard wouldn't let me in, and people started coming back from lunch, you know. So I got on the other side of the crowd of these extras, and I kind of walked in with them and just got inside the door. I always say I got in the picture business by accident.
Mm-hmm.
Just got inside the door, and a hand fell on my shoulder, and I thought sure it was the security guard is going to stop me and throw me out. And I turned around, and it was Sol Siegel, the producer of All Western Pictures. And he told me at that time they had tested about 17 fellows up to that time, and they hadn't found what they wanted. And he said, I never entered his mind until I walked through that door, and that's why he stopped me. So I signed my contract there October the 13th, 1937, and in January, I made my first picture under Western Stars.
Isn't that something? I always enjoy watching that picture. We see it at home sometime, and that was a great picture. Do you know that?
Well, it got me off to a good start. It was voted the best Western of the year in the Beat Pictures, and I went to third place in box office. We premiered it all over the United States and all the big cities, even on Broadway in New York, and I got off to a real good start. And of course, we had a great cast, old Smiley Burnett. We did a lot of pictures with Gene, and he did quite a few with me.
Smiley's in this one.
Yes.
Yeah, let's us sit back and really enjoy the Happy Trails. How did you get that name, Roy Rogers?
Well, first of all, the studio, when they signed me up, they said, we got to do something about your name. So Leonard Sly doesn't sound very Western, and I have to agree with him. But anyway, even though I'm part Indian, I just...
Distinctive anyway.
So they got together, and, you know, I used Dick Weston for a little while when I first signed up out there. So they called in all the officials, and we sit around the table, and they started kicking different names around, and somebody came up with Rogers. And I loved that name simply because I love Will Rogers so well.
Yeah.
He was so popular at that time, and I had the opportunity of doing a show with him one time.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, I liked the Rogers part of it, and they talked about John Rogers, Bill Rogers, whatever, you know, a whole bunch of first names. And somebody came up with Roy. Well, I knew a kid named Leroy when I was a kid. He and I didn't get along very well, so I didn't know whether I wanted that or not. So the more I said it, the better I liked it, Roy Rogers. And finally I decided, well, that sounds all right to me. So we used it, and I've had it ever since. And it got so confusing later on in life with as the years rolled on, I had properties in your automobile, your driver's license. I had to change everything.
Yes.
So I had it changed legally so I could have it all one, and the kids' names were all changed and everything.
Well, you know, your name is what they call euphonious, just as mine is. Mine was given
How'd you get yours?
Well, mine was given to me by a program director at Louisville, Kentucky, at WHAS. Mm-hmm. And he concocted the name Dale Evans because he said it wasn't easily misspelled, and announcers could not possibly mispronounce it. So that's the way, you know, my name was really Francis Smith. You were Leonard Sly, and I was Francis Smith. Now let's sit back and enjoy today's feature, Under Western Stars. Thank you.
hurry up there. I'm getting hungry.
Come on, Roy. Hey, somebody's shooting.
No.
Why, there too. I heard them.
Sound like it's over to the dam. Let's get going.
The force that's necessary. I'll have the sheriff over from his ranch right away. Hello, operator. Give me 21, party in.
Hello?
Hello, sheriff. There's another fight at the dam. Those rangers are broken loose again.
Well, why don't you give them some order then?
That's our business. Are you going to do your duty, or do we have to kill some of those fools?
All right, I'll get out there as soon as I can.
I bet that's Lem and Hank. They wasn't fooling when they said they was going to raid the dam.
I guess you're right.
Hey, there's a couple more of them company guards.
Yeah. Well, I'll stop them.
Might as well surrender.
Hold it.
All right, keep him up.
Hey, you.
Let's get to that bell.
Hey, wait a minute. There's some horsemen coming down there. It's probably the sheriff. You better go home and take care of that arm. I'll get the water to you.
All right, Roy.
Well, we've got to work fast. Blow the lock and open that valve. Wait a minute, Sheriff. Hold it.
Don't you point that gun at me, Roy.
I don't know how to keep you waiting, Sheriff.
The old-timers are getting this water and eat it mighty bad.
I'm going to have to take you in.
Take it easy. We'll go along to jail peaceably as soon as we get enough water. But not until we do.
I said take it easy.
That's a fine way for you to act. Roy Rogers, son of a congressman, fighting the water company.
If my dad had lived, there wouldn't have been any water company.
Just the same, the law's the law. And property's property.
And there goes ours, 100 feet a second. Make them turn off that water.
Got any other way of shutting that water off?
There ain't another valve wheel like that in the whole county.
right, Roy. There ain't no use you hold us here any longer.
Don't be downhearted, Sheriff.
You won't be so chipper when you get behind bars, Roy.
Behind jail bars, huh? Well, Sheriff, that reminds me.
Send my mail to the county jail.
Send our mail to the county jail. Tell our saddle pals tonight if they've got to lose two lives. Send our mail to the county jail. Say goodbye to your favorite gal. Say goodbye to your special gal. We're supposed to have a date, but we reckon we'll be late. Say goodbye to my favorite gal.
Tonight when coyotes howl and mountain lions growl, I'll be watching the moon and counting the stars.
Can't you see me looking through those jail bars?
Pass the hand and collect our bail. Pass the hand and collect our bail. If they ask you where I am, say I'm in an awful jam. Send that bail to the county jail.
I thought you said you was coming along peaceably.
Well, I did, but Nellie didn't.
Once a fire horse, always a fire horse, Frog.
You mean every time that knothead hears a bell, she's going to act like that?
That's right.
She ain't with me. I'll give her a good selling before anybody finds out about them tricks.
Stop this noise. You're disturbing the meeting.
Well, Roy, my boy, I'm glad to see you.
Well, how are you, Mayor?
Fine. I see you brought all your boys to town for the meeting. Come right in, boys.
They can't. They're under arrest.
What's the charge? I don't want Roy to miss the meeting.
He's charged with trespassing on the water company's property, fighting with their guards, and stealing their water.
Hooray for Roy!
Hooray! If that's the case, I'll hold court right here and now. I'm sorry, boys, but I'll have to punish you. I fine you for disturbing the peace. $1 in court cost. No, you can pay the clerk later. Come on, you're late already.
We'll be right back with Under Western Stars on the Happy...
Representative, go away, please. For two times in Washington, let us remember. Let us remember. Just a moment. Just a moment.
Wait a minute. Pardon me. But there happens to be a meeting going on here.
Well, I'm sorry, Richards.
As the son of a former congressman, you should have more respect for a public meeting. It seems to me that you should get here in time in order to be posted.
Well, I'm already posted.
Oh, you are you?
Sure. Mayor Biggs started out by talking about high water rates. Then he showed a picture of Congressman Scully and denounced him plenty. Then Mayor Jenkins of Hilton City, founded in 1848, said the water was free then that ought to be free now, and it was time the federal government did something about it, by gosh. And you, as manager of the water company, said that I'd like to lower the water rates, but we're losing money.
Marvelous, Roy, marvelous.
Practically word for word.
But how did you know?
Well, that's easy. You've all been saying the same thing since my dad was congressman.
Wait a minute. I still have the floor. As I was saying before I was so rudely interrupted, let me remind you that Congressman Scully is the only man among us fitted to go to Washington and represent...
The Great Western Water and Power Company.
The Great Western... I mean... I still say that the best man fitted to represent you in Washington is the man whose face you see on that poster.
The people's friend.
Folks, I just held court for a man who really deserves that title. He was brought before me for fighting the water company. Now, are we going to send him to jail?
No!
Shall we send him to Washington like we did his father?
Yes! Yeah.
Take a wire. Mr. John B. Fairbanks, president of the Great Western Water and Power Company, Washington, D.C.
Look at that, Andrews.
Rogers for congressman. He hasn't a chance.
What do you know about Western politics? You're a Washington attorney. Why, with beating up our men and stealing our water, that boy is a hero to those people out there.
Well, forget all about him before Election Day. See no cause for alarm?
Oh, you don't, eh? Then you need glasses. We're leaving for Sageville tonight with Congressman Scully.
Oh, but, Dad, we can't leave tonight. Oh, we're just mailing out the invitation to our reception.
Postpone it.
Postpone it?
Oh, hello, Richard.
Oh, how do you do, Mr. Fairbanks?
You know my daughter?
How do you do?
Mr. Andrews?
Glad to see you, Andrews.
And Congressman Scully, of course.
Richard.
Welcome home, Congressman. Your campaign is on full blast.
Campaign, my foot. Folks have never elected anybody.
Somewhere out there on the prairie alone, my guardian angel divine is there at rest. Somewhere in the west, that kind dear mother of mine,
he'll get that way.
You bet your life he will. Don't forget there's plenty of women voters. What do you think, Eleanor? Would you vote for him?
He has a nice voice.
And that's all he's got.
He can't campaign without advertising. He has no money for that.
Well,
You don't need money for advertising if you have brains.
Brains?
Yes, brains. Get hold of Roger. Tell him I want to see him at my hotel. Important and personal business.
Yes, sir.
We'll be right back with Underwood.
My boy, you're doing fine.
Thanks. Well, the campaign manager.
Well, everything's under control.
Hello, ma'am.
Hi.
Hello, Rogers. Can I speak to you privately for a minute?
Anything you have to say to me is all right for my friends to hear.
Hello, boys.
Hello.
Hello, Frog.
Hi.
Very funny, boys. Very funny. Mr. Fairbanks would like to see you over at his hotel. He said it was very important and personal.
Sure, why not? Tell him I'll be over tomorrow.
Okay.
I bet that guy Fairbanks is scared, and he's going to talk turkey, you see.
Maybe. Anyway, it'll give me a chance to tell him what I think of him. And that'll be plenty. 50% cut on water rates. Don't make me laugh, Mr. Fairbanks. Let me tell you something, you coot. You've run this country into the ground long enough. 60%? Now, I didn't come here to haggle, Mr. Fairbanks. It's 75% or nothing. So I'm driving a hard bargain, Emma. Well, that's too bad. But here's my last word. If you don't knuckle down, we'll run you and your cutthroat crowd right out of business.
Bravo! Bravissimo! Keep going, partner. You got him on the ropes.
Hello. I don't generally talk to myself like this. I was just sort of rehearsing.
Well, I'm doing very well, too. But how about putting a little more emphasis on your exit line? As I presume it is your exit line.
Probably. Old man Fairbanks is apt to kick me out when I get that far.
I gather you're not exactly an admirer of John Fairbanks.
He's plenty tough. Probably the kind of a man who beats his wife.
He does. I heard he shellacks his daughter on occasion. But then she probably deserves it, so...
No doubt she does. If I'm elected, I'll get federal water for this state if I have to hog-tie every politician in Washington.
Good for you. I hope you're elected.
Thanks. Well, I guess we'll be going.
Well, I'm going that way, too. We could ride along together.
Swell.
Daughter doing with Rogers?
Huh?
How do I know?
Well, I don't like it.
Tell that to Eleanor and see what happens.
Well, gentlemen, may I present Mr. Rogers? This is Tom Andrews, Mr. Richards, your worthy opponent, Congressman Scully.
How are you?
And my father, Mr. Fairbanks.
Your father?
Yes.
Oh, by the way, Dad, Mr. Rogers considers you a skinflint, a penny-pinching pirate, and what was that?
Sounds to me like you just about covered the territory.
Beat it, Brett. We want to talk business. Come on.
Oh, that reminds me, Fairbanks. Is it true you beat your daughter?
No. But it's a darn good idea. Sit down. You seem to have a lot of common sense, Rogers. I think you're the man I need to look after some of my business interests.
That'd mean giving up my campaign for Congress, wouldn't it?
Well, yes, it would. But your salary would be three times as much as you'd make as a congressman.
Thanks, but I have a family weakness for going to Washington. I'd like to see some of the places my dad told me about.
Would four times as much money interest you?
No, or ten times as much.
You might regret passing up a mighty good proposition, young man.
Now I'll make you one. Either your company cuts water rates to the bone, or I'll get federal control of water in this state when I go to Washington.
When you go to Washington? Well, you're not there yet, Mr. Rogers.
Imagine a congressman dressed like that.
Take take off those clothes.
Well, what's the matter with them?
Well, this for one thing.
Hey!
And this.
Why, what did...
And those pretty spats. The voters want a man to represent them, not a city dude. You're going to be a man of the people. You're going to wear Western clothes and ride a horse.
A horse?
Yes.
I can't ride.
We'll ride.
What?
Yes.
Horse beneath me once more.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's a round-by-round description. The son of the saddled horse has just run away with him, and Congressman Roy Rogers has rescued him from a horse trough.
Rogers elected. Letting a hick rancher outsmart us.
You insisted that I ride a horse. I told you
Oh, shut up and get out of here.
Well, now, that's the way you feel about
it. Get out before I lose my temper.
No, you don't.
Whipped by a smart aleck yokel.
How does it feel to take a licking, Dad?
Licking? Yeah, this is only round one. We're leaving for Washington, too. I'll block him there at every turn.
Uses perfume.
Thanks for the send-off, folks. And don't worry. I'm going to see that water bill goes through pronto. I figure I'll be back in about a week.
Now me, being Congressman Roy Rogers, is here personal executive and secretary. I promise to the front...
Congressman Marlowe's office, please. Good morning. Congressman Rogers calling Congressman Marlowe again. Oh. Well, when do you expect him? Yes, please have him call me back.
I don't know what Marlowe has an office for. He's never in it.
Well, he's got to have some place where you can find out that he ain't in.
Anything important?
Oh, no, just the usual 411 Constitution is wanting to know where that federal water is you promised.
Well, so do I.
Ain't there nobody else you can see about that water bill?
No, sir. Marlowe's the money man, and he has to be seen. Hmm.
Who's that from, Marlowe?
No, it's not even signed. But say, listen to this. If you want to meet Congressman Marlowe, join the fox hunt near his country estate next Saturday.
Hey, sounds like a jailbreak. We better get out of here, them bloodhounds is vicious.
The hunt started. Come on.
Against one poor little fox. They ain't no justice. Hey, that horse has run away with her.
Your horse was running away.
No, but the fox is. Why'd have one is brushing another 100 yards if you hadn't played lock and bar?
I'm awful sorry.
Oh, well, it doesn't matter. See, tell me, how's the singing congressman making out from Washington?
Not so good. The only luck I've had so far is meeting you again. I've tried to follow your advice about seeing Congressman Marlowe, but he dodges me like a wild Mustang.
My advice?
Nobody else I know uses perfume writing paper. It's mighty nice of you to show me the ropes, even if Marlowe is too busy crashing society.
Well, he's not crashing society. Congressman Marlowe gave this fox hunt because he wanted a political favor from one of his guests.
Well, like a medicine man putting on a show to get his customers in mind to buy.
Yes, that's it. You see, here in Washington, that's the trick to get to the ear of the right person.
Well, I couldn't very well give a fox hunt.
No. No, but you could give a party.
Well, who'd come?
Oh, look.
Get these hound dogs out of here. Wild away.
Hey, what's happened?
Shoo! Wild away, get out of here. Get on the way from here. Get out of here. Get these hound dogs out of here.
Oh, Dad, you remember Mr. Rogers, don't you?
What? Oh, yes, sure. Well, how do you do?
Oh, Congressman Marlowe. This is Congressman Rogers.
Glad to know you, Mr. Rogers.
Well, how do you do, Congressman? I'd like a few words with you. I want to ask you to...
To be a guest at next Tuesday evening at the Fairview Country Club. Oh, all of you, Mr. Rogers is giving a surprise party. Doesn't that sound exciting? Oh, you'll be there, won't you, Senator Wilson?
Certainly, Miss Fairbanks.
And no party would be complete without you and Mrs. Marlowe, Congressman.
I adore surprise parties. Of course we'll come, won't we, Edward? Why, I think it's perfectly sweet of Mr. Rogers to invite us all. Don't you, dear?
I don't know anything about these Eastern parties.
We'll make it Western.
Well, I'll send a wire to Larry and the boys.
a little moonshine in your mouth and lose your home from Grandfield back to the lady in Lee. Al, the man you left and right, your partner rides and left in a hurry up, boys, and don't be slow. There's chicken in the bread pan picking up dough, and to meet your partner all slow. Meet your honey and a pat her on the head. She don't like biscuits, feed her cornbread, and chew my tobacco and squirt on the wall and swing that gal she ain't too tall.
Roger certainly has a peculiar idea of entertainment.
Yes, isn't it quaint? I don't know when I've had such a good time.
So far, folks, all you've seen of ranch life has been a lot of fun. But there's another side I want you to see. And that's a surprise, I promise. These first scenes are the way our ranches used to look. Every range had grass like that in the summer. One winter covered it with snow, we had plenty of that good alfalfa for feed. We fattened our beef on that grain. Every valley and every canyon had a stream of running water. Then nature took a hand. Every year we had less and less rain. This is what happened. Dry spells, drought, and dust storms. After the dust storm, this is what is left. That's Glenn Saunders' house. He lost his two children from dust pneumonia. That's Luke Chalmers' place. He just gave up and moved away, never even stopped to dig up his equipment. Those cattle are Dave Peters. He lost 150 head, which meant every cent he owned. All of this tragedy and ruin, ladies and gentlemen, because of lack of water. In times like these, folks just naturally turn to prayer.
Dust in the skies, dust on the trail, dust in my eyes, dust. Can't see the sun, can't find my way, the dust has won. The cattle and the sheep, better down to sleep, seem to realize their pain. The vultures in the sky know the time is nigh. Will they fly away or away? Oh, Lord, please ease my pain. Oh, Lord, where is your rain and sunshine? Must it be? Can it be eternity? It was the home where the buffalo roamed, where the deer and the antelope played. Here was a place where the cattle would graze, the corn and alfalfa once swayed. Where are the ranchers, the cow-punching crowd? What has become of the range? Out of the blue came a threatening cloud, causing this awful change. Must it be? Can this be eternity? Oh, Lord, have mercy on poor me.
We'll be right back with Underwood.
You know, this picture's really topical because those dust storms were horrible at that time. Remember?
Oh, they were natural, too. We made this picture up in Lone Pine, and there's a place called the Alabamas up there. And a funny sequence, it was in the pictures all about the dust storms they were having in those days back in Kansas and Oklahoma, where they exchanged real estate day after day. And a lot of cattle starved to death, and so they were fighting, and there's a political fight. to get a dam in and where they could get water and irrigation and stuff like that. So I was a young congressman at that time.
Uh-huh.
I was a cowboy, but I was elected to Congress and went to Washington and had a lot of fun back there working with the politicians. But the picture was written for the about those dust storms, and my leading lady at that time was Carol Hughes.
Mm-hmm.
And, of course, we had Smiley Burnett as my sidekick.
Yes.
But we were on location doing this picture, and we had a wind sequence we had to do to show what the wind storms were like. And we had wind machines there and everything, but we got ready to shoot, and the darndest windstorm came up you ever seen, and like it blew the equipment over and blew the reflectors over and lights. And so they got out there and shot everything right in that regular windstorm. So it was a natural one. So
realistic.
It came in handy, and it was fun to do.
Realistic picture making.
Yeah.
You know, I understand that the original title was Washington Cowboy.
Yes, it was.
You know, people have asked me a lot of times, why doesn't Roy run for president? Have you ever considered running for office?
Are you kidding? No, I haven't. I'm very happy doing what I'm doing, and it's been very good to me. And getting started, this picture is voted the best Western of the year, uh-huh. as I said before. And I'd rather stay where I am and be with you, Mother.
Well, thank you.
Okay.
So let's sit back and watch this picture.
Rather unethical, but very effective. I'm going west in about 10 days, and I'll get you relief if I find those conditions existing.
You have my support on that water bill, too, Rogers.
Oh, Dad, it looks as though you've lost round two.
Well, you needn't rub it in. Think it's funny, do you?
Fairbanks, I had no idea that conditions in your state were so serious.
They aren't. I'll take you out there and show you that Rogers misrepresented things.
Well, I hope you're right for your own good. After all, it's your water company that's on the spot, you know.
Young woman, you helped stage this entertainment. Do you realize it might ruin my water company?
Oh, one of your water companies.
Are you in love with this cowboy?
Oh. Oh, I don't know. Yeah.
Well, you tell him for me that he's in for the doggonest licking he ever had.
Oh, yes, I'll tell him. But he won't believe me.
Hey, that was swell. And the way you was calling them ranchers out by their names, you even had me fooled. You think they's neighbors of ours.
Oh, weren't they?
No. Those pictures were taken in another state, Elnor. I couldn't get a newsreel of her own dust storm.
Tell me, my friend, is your middle name Barnum by any chance?
Oh, no, his middle name's James.
Oh, I see, after Jesse.
Oh, no.
Leaving so soon, Mr. Fairbank?
Yes. And I'll wipe that grin off your face yet.
Never mind, you were grand.
With your help. When will I see you? I'm leaving for the West pretty soon.
Now, what a coincidence. So are we.
Eleanor.
Oh, yes, Daddy, I'm coming.
And so I take great pleasure in introducing to you the most important man who ever hit Old Sage County, and the only man who can give us federal controlled water, Congressman Marley.
Fellow citizens, as chairman of the Appropriations Committee, I'm authorized to announce that we are here to make a study of the drought conditions in this section.
Better cover up fast, Congressman, before the newspapers get wind of this.
However, we have already learned that conditions are not as bad as we were led to believe, and we find that existing utilities are quite adequate for the present. Now, that is all. Thank you for your kind welcome. I said your methods were unethical, but I underrated you. You're nothing but a cheap trickster.
I admit the film I showed you wasn't taken in this state. The conditions here are just as bad, if not worse.
As far as I'm concerned, young man, that bill never will be passed.
I'll back you up on that, Marlowe.
I had a right to trick you when the lives of these folks depend on water. If you don't think this country's dry, just look it over and see for yourself.
Sorry, but I'm not interested.
But I came all this way to see the drought conditions and the dust storm.
Now don't be silly, dear. There aren't any.
I told you I'd wipe that smile off your face.
You've had very capable help. I should have known better than to trust a woman with a secret.
We'll be right back with Underwood.
Edward, I'm so hot and dusty. Perhaps we'd better not go any farther after all.
Sorry, dear, but it's too late now. You wanted to go, so I promised Mr. Fairbanks I'd meet him at the dam.
But Edward...
Except the drivers, we're taking the cars.
This is an outrage. I'm Congressman Marlowe.
You can't leave us out here afoot.
You can use our horses.
Well, there's only one thing to do. Take the horses and ride back to Sageville.
What a dry country. I don't see how people live here. It wasn't always like this. It wouldn't be now if the farmers had water.
Evidently, you still believe in motion pictures.
Listen.
There must be a camp ahead.
And that means a drink of water.
The old chuck wagon's rhythm starts about noon. Then you'll hear those cowhands sipping soup very soon. And there's music to the rhythm, music to the rhythm, music to the rhythm of the range. Adiolo, diolo, 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 diolo.
Nice of you to drop in.
Hello, Congressman.
Don't tell me you're making an official tour of the drought section after all.
We're making a tour, all right, but not an official one.
Why, we were held up by bandits, and they took our cars away from us and made us ride these horrible, bumpy horses.
We'll tell you about that later. Right now, we're too thirsty to talk.
Gee, that's too bad.
Yeah, and ain't that tough? We only got about a pint of water left. We done give it to the horse.
You see, we didn't expect to have any visitors.
You mean you can't even give us a drink?
Well, we might find enough for the ladies, but the men will have to wait till we reach Larkin's place tomorrow. Get the canteen, Frog. You folks, just make yourselves at home. Boys, unsaddle the horses and fix them a bite to eat. That's all there is.
You can see a dale and the winding trail when a cowboy sings a song. You see grazing herds and the prairie. Cowboy sings a song. When he sings, get along, little doggy, get along. You can see an old corral. When you hear yodel-o-dle-o-dle-o, you see him ride. riding to his gal. Can't you see the ways and the place to rest when a cowboy sings a song?
Is it much farther to this Larkin ranch?
Not so much, just the other side of the river.
River? Did you say river? Where?
Right there. Used to run bank full when everybody got the water from it.
Oh, but what happened?
Your company built a dam and dried it up.
Dried it up? Well, everything seems dried up in this country.
That's what I tried to tell you.
Say, that looks like a water wagon. Hey! Hey! Stop!
Can we have some water?
I reckon you can, mister. Right around behind.
Come on.
For Mrs. Marlowe.
Marlowe? Ain't you the congressman that was going to do so much for us ranchers and then change your mind?
Well, yes, but then conditions were misrepresented and...
Well, you sure fixed it so I got to haul water 20 miles. None of you get a drop.
Oh, say, now, wait. You can't. Oh, hold on. That isn't right.
Oh, okay.
Hey, come on, now.
Edward.
Hey, wait a minute. Listen,
that's not right.
We've got to have water.
Why didn't you help me stop him? He has no right
just
to refuse.
Just as much right as your company had to refuse the rancher's water.
We'll be right back with Under Western Stars on the Happy Trail.
Roy, they really worked you on this picture.
They sure did.
You were starring in your very first picture. Uh-huh. That's really terrific. A lot of people don't get a chance to do that. Do you know that? They have to really pay their dues with bit parts. Well, you must have made a pretty good salary.
Oh, I was killing them. I'm telling you, I was just coming out of the Depression, you know, and I plowed corn for $4 a week when I was a kid. And I worked in a shoe factory at about $25 a week.
Yeah.
And this is the first time I ever made any money. And I want you to know I was really making a bundle. After especially comparing today what they make on these TV shows. You hear them quitting jobs because they only make $35,000
an episode.
Yeah.
Yes.
I started out making my first picture at $75 a week. And boy, I was rich.
Every week, huh?
Yeah, every week. But I mean...
That's not enough to feed poor old Trigger.
Well, you couldn't even hire somebody today to mow your lawn for that.
That's right.
But anyway, it was a great era. I wouldn't take anything in the world for the era that my life has spanned over the period of back to the horse and buggy days up until the man on the moon. And we're here in the beautiful town of Knoxville.
Great.
Saying hello to everybody, and
that's right.
It's fun.
And so let's get right back to watching our picture, Under Western Stars. Look! What is it? A cyclone?
No, it's a dust storm, and it's coming our way.
Dust storm? What'll we do?
You saw pictures of one, Mr. Marlowe. Now you're going to see the real thing.
We've got to find shelter. Come on.
Thank you. howdy, Roy.
Well, where's your husband, Mrs. Larkin?
He's going to town for grub. He ought to be back pretty soon.
Have you any water?
We have some now, mister. But the cistern will be full of dust after this storm.
Cistern? I thought you said the Great Western Pipeline ran through here.
Well, I'd been informed.
Of course, the water company wouldn't misinform anybody, would it, Andrews?
The pump's in the corner right over there. Help yourselves. Anything we got here, you're welcome to.
Do you have dust pneumonia out here, Rogers?
No, you needn't worry. We don't even have dust storms here. They have them in another state.
You needn't rub it in.
I can't stand much more of this.
I thought you were the one who wanted to see the dust storm.
Oh!
Sakes, mister, you don't owe me nothing. Roy paid me yesterday.
But we weren't here yesterday.
So the whole thing was a frame-up, eh?
Everything but the dust storm. That was an added attraction.
You mean the hold-up and the water wagon were planned?
That's right.
I see nothing to laugh at.
Young man, I want to shake you by the hand. Your methods are not only unethical, they're phenomenal. But don't you worry. I'll okay that water bill.
Thanks.
Roy, the ranchers are headed to blow up the dam.
Rogers, if they blast that dam, they'll lose government support.
I'll stop them.
I'm Congressman Marlowe. Head for the dam and step on it.
Thanks for the warning. We'll teach them a lesson.
Stay here a while and make sure.
Yeah.
see them?
Yes, we turned them back. They've gone over the hill. Come on, get back here and get down.
We'll never get to the dam now. Unhook them horses.
All we got to do is to turn that dynamite wagon loose down that hill, blast the ditch and the water can't get to the dam. Get that wagon to roll. That's the dynamite wagon.
We've got to get out of here.
No, wait.
We'll be right back with Under Western Stars on the Happy Trails Theater.
Rogers thinks that's well.
He's won the fight for water. What does a man want now?
I'm out to win a bigger stake, and you can show me how.
If you want a happy life, just say yes and be the wife of Rogers, the congressman.
Smiley Burnett was a terrific guy. You must have really enjoyed working with him.
He was a lot of fun. He knows more jokes than you can shake a stick at. He was just Frog Milhouse, that's his name. You know, he made a lot of pictures with Gene. This was my first picture. And later on, he did other pictures with me. But he was a great guy. And I just loved to be working with him.
You know, Smiley Burnett had a heart as big as the outdoors.
Mm-hmm.
Remember all those children that he adopted and that one little boy that was in such bad shape that he took? We had trailers very close to each other out of a place called Paradise Cove in California. And on Sundays, Smiley would invite Roy and me and our children up in his trailer with all this bunch of children, and he made his famous buttermilk pancakes. They were so tasty and so good. I'll never forget it. He had a great heart.
Yes, he did. He's a wonderful guy.
Well, we hope you've enjoyed this film. I know Roy enjoyed making it very much, and I always enjoy looking at it. So until the next time on Happy Trails Theater.
Goodbye, good luck, and may the good Lord take a liking to you.